Hello, everybody. Paul Richards here with PTZOptics.
Matthew Davis.
In episode 31 of our vlog, we're going to be taking a first look at xSplit, not digging in too deep, but definitely giving you a good idea of what it can do.
Yeah.
So let's dig right in vlog number 31, xSplit. We're going to show you how to integrate our cameras. We're going to show you how to do some RTSP streaming.
Yeah.
Which should be nice. And yeah, let's dig right in. So let's go over to xSplit here, and we'll talk about the pricing in a minute, but this is xSplit.
Yeah, so one of the nice things you might notice right off the bat, if you're not familiar with it, you're presented with two nice options. If you like to read, there's manual that you can read right off the bat, and if you're somebody who likes watching things, hey, video tutorials. They're trying to cater to both audiences.
Probably the first thing you're going to want to do is add your camera, and it's not available because we're using it on our other software, so I'm going to go ahead and disable it in our other software, and boom, here we are in 1080p. It's pulling through crystal clear.
Yeah, looks beautiful.
No problems with the quality here. One of my earliest issues I had was it was in 640 by 360 over here.
Yeah, that'll definitely degrade the quality.
And I was like, what is going on? It doesn't look good. Not happy with this. Okay, it was just the resolution over here. So first thing, if you're just starting with this. And I guess we should show the pricing, because it's like, why? Why are we looking at this? You can start off at $2.50 a month.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty fantastic. You know, that there isn't much of a barrier to entry at that point. If you just even want to try this, you know, you're out $2.50, $5, maybe $10 at the most here for 2 months of trying it.
Now, there's a little asterisk here that, like, that's the 36-month price. And if you were to buy 36 months, we're talking about $750.
Yeah.
So it actually, you know, we don't want to pay this up front, most likely. I would highly suggest whatever they're charging, it is a little interesting how this works.
But that being said, there's also a trial for it.
There's a free trial, and I think that's for 5 licenses or something. But it is the least expensive option that you can get, for sure. And you can start out with just 1 month.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the key here. So if you need something to get off the bat, and you don't want to do Open Broadcaster, which is like open source and very difficult.
Yeah, and it's very simple. You know, Open Broadcaster is great for some basic streams, but if you want to get a little bit more elaborate with your production quality, that's where xSplit comes in as a nice middle ground offering.
So a couple of things I wanted to show. This is really, really simple. And in this Friday in our live show, we're going to show how to sell like QVC. And really all you need is like 2 or 3 scenes. You know, an intro scene, a product sales scene, and then an outro. And that's all you need. So you can see right here that there's like 3 scenes. You could add more if you wanted to. So here's scene 1. We're going to consider this scene 1. In a second here, we're going to show you how to do a chroma key, simple background. Scene 2, let's set up an RTSP stream. So RTSP streaming, for those of you out there who might not be familiar with that, it's streaming over the network. So we've got a camera here that we're going to pull in over the network. There it is there.
Yay. I
believe I have it controllable right there. There's us again.
Yay.
So why don't we do one more camera? Got another extra one over here. We'll show full screen, and then we can layer the layers down here. And this is just kind of a picture-in-picture.
As you can see, very, very intuitive, easy to work with the content. Even gives you the constraint box to make a nice visual layout of it, so that stuff's just not randomly placed.
And then you've just got your scenes. So, I mean, I could see intro scene is just a video. You know, second scene is your chroma keyed background. Third scene is your outro. And it's just click, 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 done.
Yeah.
It's one of the simplest. I mean, it is probably the simplest thing I've ever seen.
Yeah. I mean, they really have done an excellent job of not intimidating you by using this right off the bat. It's very inviting.
So what I just did there is I right-clicked the video, and this is this for any input. You can right-click it and change some things. You know, you can, is there an audio source built in? Well, our cameras do support that if we wanted to. Do we want to adjust the colors a little bit? Or do we want to do a color key, which I know a lot of our customers have been doing. So I just clicked the color, and I'm just going to edit it just a little. That's actually coming through pretty good.
Yeah.
Actually really good, honestly. This one's coming through great. We have good lighting. So if you don't have good lighting, this is not going to work right off the bat.
Yeah, it's going to take a lot more work if you have poor lighting. If your chroma key background is not flat, that also can lead to problems. A few mm-hmm. things to look at if you are having trouble.
And we do have some suggestions on chroma keying tips, which I think we did a couple videos back.
Yeah.
And we've got some tips and tricks, and just reach out to us if you have an issue. We will help you. But there's a chroma key background. There's another background. So very, very simple stuff. It doesn't get much easier than this.
No.
So that's it, really. We just wanted to very briefly show you guys simply what's possible. And then in the future, I'd like to do some more tutorials, some more tips and tricks. I'm going to maybe do some free... So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
We hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit about xSplit, and we'll have more to come for you.
Have a nice day, everybody.
Bye.